can we, as adults, grow new nerve cells? Well, actually, we do. And this is a phenomenon that we call neurogenesis. So now, Robert is not a neuroscientist. And when he went to medical school, he was not taught what we know now, that the adult brain can generate new nerve cells, the hippocampus, the most exciting part of the brain when it comes to neurogenesis. So this is this gray structure in the center of the brain. And what we know since already very long is that this is important for learning and memory and mood and emotion. However, what we have learned more recently is that this is one of the unique structures of the adult brain where new neurons can be generated. And if we slice through the hippocampus and zoom in, what you actually see here in blue is a newborn neuron in an adult mouse brain. So when it comes to human brain, my colleague Jonas Friesen from the Karolinska Institute has estimated that we produce 700 new neurons per day in the hippocampus. By the time we will turn 50, we will have all exchanged the neurons we were born with in that structure with adult-born neurons. So why are these new neurons important and what are their functions? So first, we know that they're important for learning and memory. And in the lab, we have shown that if we block the ability of the adult brain to produce new neurons in the hippocampus, then we block certain memory abilities. And this is especially new and true for spatial recognition. So like how you navigate your way in the city. Collectively, now we think we have enough evidence to say that neurogenesis is a target of choice if we want to improve memory formation or mood or even prevent their decline associated with aging or associated with stress. So the next question is, can we control neurogenesis? The answer is yes. So learning will increase the production of this new neuron. Stress will decrease the production of new neurons in the hippocampus. Sleep deprivation, it will decrease neurogenesis. How about sex? It will increase the production of new neurons. So how about getting older? So neurogenesis rate will decrease as we get older, but this is still occurring. And then finally, how about running? So activity impacts on neurogenesis, but that's not all. What you eat will have an effect on the production of new neurons in the hippocampus. Calorie restriction of 20 to 30% will increase neurogenesis. Intermittent fasting, so spacing the time between your meal, will increase neurogenesis. Intake of flavonoid, which is contained in dark chocolate or blueberry, will increase neurogenesis. Omega-3 fatty acid present in fatty fish like salmon will increase the production of these new neurons. Conversely, a diet rich in high saturated fat will have a negative impact on neurogenesis. Ethanol, intake of alcohol, will decrease neurogenesis. And then finally, let me point out the last one. Soft diet impairs neurogenesis as opposed to food that require mastication, chewing, or crunchy food. It's not only what you eat, but it's also the texture of the food, when you eat it, and how much of it you eat.